on the name, Ed, it says what it is on the label. It's an AI chip.
Right. Just 200.
200, apparently. Just how big of a rivalry will this pose to NVIDIA?
Yeah, I mean, the stock reaction, a gain of almost 9%, biggest jump since early April. The stock's now trading at its highest level since July of last year, shows that this is real. The AI 200 is an NPU, a neural processing unit. It's just a fancy way of saying it's a purpose-designed accelerator card for AI machine learning tasks. And what Qualcomm is saying is that it ships next year, 2026. The first customer is Humain, the Saudi Arabian AI startup. It's basically a holding or umbrella company for the nation's data center build-out. And they're committing to 200 megawatts, which is modest in the scheme of everything that's going on. But now as we approach a 10% gain, you know, the market is there for Qualcomm to participate in. It's one that they've not been in so far. So it's a very interesting reaction here.
Ed, you have, as the co-host of Bloomberg Tech and a journalist who just breaks news on a regular basis, a better view than most at the race to beat NVIDIA in terms of building chips. We've heard about other competitors before, but how close is anyone coming, and how worried should Jensen Huang be?
Well, again, the reaction in Qualcomm shares shows that the market is taking this product seriously. But it is a small and early entry into a market in which NVIDIA holds a monopoly. The issue is that if you take Qualcomm as a case study, it's a future product. 2026 is next year. And the way that NVIDIA has been able to hold a lead out over AMD and Qualcomm now entering that market and other specialist silicon names like Grok with a Q, is that it basically has told the market its plans for the next 5 years. So we already know what the next generation GPU from NVIDIA is and when it's going to come. And so if you are planning data center capacity and doing deals all over the planet, you know, we already know that NVIDIA has, you know, future deals in 2026 at the same time that Qualcomm's made this announcement with Humain. And that's the difficulty that these new entrants to the market are dealing with. Then it will become, what is the performance of this accelerator card? Is it better at certain tasks in the inference context than NVIDIA's gear? We just don't know because it's not yet deployed.